want to show you how to put this window in, and basically we're talking about how to flash the window. I'm not too worried about these windows anyway. They are inset, you know, 2 feet from the outside edge, and we're really close to the eave. I mean, they're not going to see any weather. But anywho, talk these days is of creating a pan for the bottom. And imagine, you know, condensation or water or anything, anywhere water could get in and start coming down this window, you want it going outside. Outside means out over this house wrap, not inside the house wrap. Like they do build pans that have a little bit of slope to them you can install that assure water will head that way. I like to, you know, we can beat the inside of these sill plates up and leave the outside as nailed into the sheeting. It will not move. That creates a little slope for it. I have some shims that I can put on top of the studs or cripples to assure that, and it's going to get loud. Didn't take a whole lot of slope, and I'll put these little shims in here just to assure that that stays where I want it. Now Phil's got the Lex wrap, and this has got bits of thing on it or sticky tape. Once you stick it, I'm stealing Phil's job here. Anyway, once you stick it where you want it, it's stuck. You can't pull it back up. So we peeled the back part of the tape off. Coming from the inside of the wall, it sticks out another 3 inches or 3.5 past, and we've run it up the edges, okay? Pretty easy to see. If, you know, water comes down here, it will hit the sill and head out. So one more piece of tape. It comes in. This is just, you know, keeps that from sticking anything till the precise moment. And I just haven't figured out the best way to do this. Come on, Phil. You know, we'll work on folding the middle down, try not to get it to bubble up like that or double up, because we'll want that flange of the window to sit as flat as it can. And the idea behind this very expensive wrap here, I think Kim said this, you only buy as much of this as you need just for the sills, for something a foot. I mean, you get pretty fussy about not buying too much, especially when you're paying for it. Anyway, it will fan out around these corners. And the corners is always the hard part to get it to seal right. You know, you can run tape crosswise and do all kinds of weird stuff, but there's still that one spot that it doesn't get sealed up. So that is the nice thing about this DuPont Flex Wrap. They'll be sending me my check later. Now is the time that we put the window in the hole. I have the window inside, we have to shove it outside and install it. Windows usually come a half inch undersized from the opening that is called out on the plan. So if this were a 30-30 window called out on the plan, that's 36 inches by 36, the window would come a half inch under on both of those dimensions. That allows us to center it in the hole, make sure it's the way we like it, and not tight. You need that room 1/4 inch all the way around, which equals, you know, 1/2 inch. I like to preemptively put a couple pencils in the corners. These carpenter pencils are 1/4 inch. That gets me off the sill that 1/4 inch and starts me on my way to centering this window in the opening. You don't have to do the pencil across the bottom, but this will allow me, if I need to drop one side, I can pull a pencil out and drop one side a little bit. So, as promised, get the window in the hole. A little tighter than I like, but it'll be fine. These are double hung, you know, this upper and lower sash will raise, and each one will raise and lower. So, this could be out of square. I need to verify that it is square just by hooking on both corners. You know, it's 57.5, and this should be the same, and it is, so it's good and square. I can nail screw all 4 corners. I like to use screws for this, just sheetrock screws. You know, they put holes in here. Usually you can go in wherever you want to go. Even if I don't want to pick my own spot, I'll just put a screw in wherever I want to. These screws are sharp enough to go through about anything. And I can go ahead and pin all 4 corners. Nice and tight. I'll go ahead and put one on the top here. one of the nice things about the screws is it allows you to change your mind. Suppose there was something I didn't like. Well, if I've nailed it, now I've got a real rascal getting the nail out, and I damage things. And, I don't know, screws are kind of nice. The next thing to check would be to make sure this style on the side here, or whatever you call it, is straight. And that one is straight. And I'll check this side as well. It looks like it is also straight. Sometimes these center sections, kind of, they can bow or do weird things. You just make sure they're both the same, so that that window will want to slide straight up and down and not get stuck in the frame. Okay, so I'll put, probably two more screws on each side, and then I'll worry about the bottom. Okay, so the bottom, I'm going to want to make sure that the bottom of this sill is straight across. If I have to shove it down or up in the middle, then that's what I'll do. This looks pretty good. I'll actually shove it down just a whisker. A couple of screws across the bottom to ensure that that won't move. One nice thing about making my own hole in this window flange is that it won't move one way or another. If you're using an existing hole, when the screw gets to where the head of the screw is, it will want to center in that hole and kind of tries to move it around a little bit. Okay, so the next move here is to put some flashing on here. So we've got the sill or the pan flashing, and then I'll want to flash each side. So I'll start at the top. I'm going to extend this past the top of the window and run it past the bottom a little bit. I'm going over this window flange up to the corner of this window. The whole idea is to get this shingling effect where if water hits the wall, it does nothing but go out. You don't want it going in. I mean, that seems obvious, but we'll mention it anyway. So every move I make here, whoops, is to assure that water goes out, not in. Okay, so that nice, and it's a real nice tight seal up against the flange of that window. So if water hits the window, I mean, it can hit the window, it's going to come down, dribble over, and that pan is there. If it hits the wall, it's going to come down this corner, and because I've got the pan there, the water goes outside the pan. So I'll put this other side on, and then I'll run that piece across the top. Now I've run this tape down this side, same scenario as there. Now I'm going to run one piece across the top. There is a nail flange across the top of this window. You usually do not nail the top flange. What happens is you want the, you know, the roof is going to have different loads on it. The header there is intended to, you know, move maybe a little bit. This isn't going to move, but that's the idea. Anyway, if I were to put a nail on the top of the window or sliding glass door or something, when the, you know, heavy loads or whatever, they can break windows when they move so far. So the idea would be to leave that loose. If that needs to deflect a little bit, it can do that and not impact the window. The window can move some. Sometimes you use a big, you know, fat-headed roofing nail or something if you want to hold that back, but you do not nail through the flange. Usually the trim that you put on will get put on here and hold that, you know, the top of the window back. You won't, you know, you'll be nailing above that, but the edge of the trim will hold that flange back. The other thing I wanted to mention as I struggled to get the backside of this tape off is that on these windows comes a bunch of information. And I was telling Tim that I recommend keeping that information. Information that I recommend keeping, you know, this is a little tag on the window. It's got everything about the window, what kind of gas was put in it, what kind of UV rating it has, the U value. The U value is one of those things, they crown it PG here, 35. Windows on a new building have to meet a certain code, and that is the insulating quality of the window. That's the way they measure it. It's a weird number. But so I would know that. I know the size of the glass, and I know what the tinting is. And that's a big deal when you, if one of these were to get broken, my job would be to go pull it out and go get another pane of insulated glass to replace it. Well, if they don't know what the tint is, it looks really weird having different tints in the same hole. And especially a big, you know, wall with a bunch of windows. People have probably encountered that, you know. You get one that's clear or isn't tinted at all, or has some reflectivity to it, it's really obvious and dumb, and you end up having to go get another piece of glass. So anyway, this, you know, and I have kept these, like, big jobs I've done, I just keep them in a notebook. I stick them to paper, I put them in a notebook. It's part of what I can keep forever, or hand to the owner, or whatever. Then they'll have a record of all the windows and exactly what they were. 5/4 by 6 trim pieces are gonna go around the two windows in the back. The rest of these are already trimmed. Anyway, remember that nail flange that I put the screws through to fasten the window to the wall? Well, it sticks away from the wall, and you don't have to do this, but if I were to put this on the wall, it's pretty obvious to see that whatever the thickness of that nail flange is would hold the top of the board out. And then when these two come together, it makes for a less than perfect suture there at the corner. So, I don't know, when I have the time and the saw and whatnot, I like to take, I'll run the blade up, I don't know, 1.5 inches or so, then I'll take about a blade width off the back. Boards, top and bottom run long, and the sides will butt into them. That's kind of no brainer. Anyway, when I nail this, I would like these nails to be on layout. That means I would like to make sure I nail them into a stud or cripple in this case. The siding we're going to put on here is face nail. All the nails will be seen forever and ever. I like them to be, as close to perfect as I can get it. So, I mean, I know I could bump my tape into the end of the wall, and I know how far I would have to come off to find a stud. One easy way to do that would be to either feel across the wall or look right here. I've got the edge of a piece of plywood. I can come up here and find that edge of a piece of plywood. And, where the two pieces butt together, there's a little seam. Boom, I've just found layouts, and I want them indicated or mark it on the side of the wall, below where the trim's going to be, because I'll be holding the trim up in place, and if I mark it up here, I wouldn't be able to see it. So I'll just mark these two. Those are the only two I'm interested in. Those two are right underneath the window.
Yeah. Break even.
I moved. That's okay, right?
Yeah. You're still in the same spot. Looks like on my side.
So I'm going to put these two, this is a square butt joint, whatever you want to call it. I'm going to put some caulking in between there and just make sure that's sealed up real nice. And this is good, I don't know if it's polyurethane or whatever, but it's some really good exterior sealant. And usually whenever you get this gun out with the caulking in there, you better have a couple paper towels going with it, because you get this, you really need to be careful what this gets on, because it doesn't come off. Apply it on there, it can go to gush mode, and I'll squish it down here until that starts squishing out.